Hi, I'm George Pearson. In this Photoshop video, I'll be showing you my favorite source for finding and installing thousands of free brushes for Photoshop. Now, these can be used in any version of Photoshop. They can also be used in other programs like Photoshop Elements that use the same brush format. Now, if you like this video, make sure you click that like button and also click on share and share this video with your friends through social media. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well so you don't miss out on any videos in the future. And if you want to learn a lot more about Adobe's Photoshop program, take a look at my complete Photoshop course, and you'll find a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Adobe's Photoshop program comes with loads of brushes, and you'll find those right up here, little drop-down button right there. Here's your basic brush stuff, of course, your brush angle, your size, your hardness, and so forth. You can adjust your roundness in here as well. And in here, you'll see all of the brushes, and these are just showing a stroke, a standard stroke from that brush. If we grab this little button here and kind of pull this slider down, you'll see there's just loads and loads of brushes, and it's possible this is all you may ever need. As far as brushes go, you'll find that there are some great specially fixed brushes. Here's some dune grass and regular grass. Here's some scattered maple leaves. I've used all of this stuff before in some of my projects. Actually, this grass one here is kind of a fun way to put in fake fur. Just one of those little ways you can use something for a different use than what it's intended for. So lots of these brushes. If you keep on scrolling down, you have additional brush sets right down here. There are general brush sets. Click on the little arrow right there, you can get some general brush sets, dry media, wet media, special effects brushes. But you'll also find if you install brush sets, you can get additional brush sets down below. So you can actually have a lot of additional brushes. Now, the question is, you know, first of all, why would you want any more brushes? And it's mostly for special effects, for special uses or special needs. And the second thing is, where the heck do you find these things? Let me show you my favorite source finding additional brushes for Photoshop. Let's bring it up right here, and that's at Deviant Art. Now you can find this page. The link up here is deviantart.com, resources, applications, PS brushes, popular dash all dash time, and a lot of other additional stuff in here. I don't really want you to memorize this whole thing, so I'll put this link on the download page for this video. So you can go ahead and click on that. There's a link for that page in the description. And that page, I have a link for this page here, so you don't need to write this down. Just go ahead and go to that page to get to the link. Now, what DeviantArt is, this is a place where people put up their own artwork. A lot of great paintings and drawings in here. I have my own account here, and I put up a lot of the images from my YouTube videos up there on this site. But along with that, people also put up other stuff as well, including Photoshop brush sets. But these are the most popular, and they're ranked by most popular, so the brushes that you see here will change from time to time. You know, this thing will move around depending upon what is popular at the moment, and that popularity is based on people downloading. The more downloads, the more these will move to the top. Obviously, this is the most popular brush set in here. I'm going to scroll down and show you what a few of these things are. Here's one for doing, you know, drawings and painting. Here's some smoke and cloud brushes over here. Here's one that's good for anime. There's a lot of brushes that are good for anime if you're into that kind of artistic style. There are quite a few tech brushes in here, tech symbols and things you can drop on, and several different splatter brushes. Here's a watercolor splatter. Here's kind of a blood splatter, good for Halloween maybe. And here's some leaf. You'll find a lot of leaf things. So brushes that will save you a lot of time and energy just by being able to come in here and then download some of these things. Now, any of these brushes, you can just go ahead and download. Some of these will have a price on them. Most of them won't. For instance, here's one, $4.90 for a space brush set. Probably very interesting, but you know, again, it's a very, very low pricing. And most of these are free. Some of these will require that you simply give them credit in your artwork. You know, or if it's on your web page, you'll link back to their brush set or link back to their site. Let me show you one of those, one of my favorites down here. Right down here is Eye Brushes. I'll click on this one. Real neat brush. This artist has gone in here and actually created all of these different parts of the eyes So you can build your own eyes based upon these different parts, and you'll colorize them differently. You can even use these for enhancing regular eyes in a photograph. Now, all she asks for right down here is you get a credit to her and a link back to this page if you use this. And also, you know, favorite the page. I like to favorite these things whenever I find them. But that's not asking much. There's no cost to this. Just give her recognition that this is where you got that brush from. This is back up one step here. You want to take a look at this one right here, Cloud Brush. Click on this. It's a brush that has actually clouds in it. You can build skies and cloudy skies just by using the different brushes. Now this one doesn't have any requirements. You simply download it and use it. Now find the downloads for all these things over here on the right hand side. And it's the download button right there. So we click on this and then download to a location on your computer. I'll click on the download button. Now sometimes you may get this thing inside of DeviantArt. I don't know why this happens, but it happens quite a bit. Just go back and try it again and you should be okay. There it is. Again, that's just a weird little DeviantArt thing that tends to pop up quite a bit. Now I put my brushes into a special folder called Photoshop Brushes. I'll just download it into this brush folder. They come down as zip files, and we find this cloud zip file in this list of stuff in here. There it is. I've already downloaded that. It's right down there. Simply unzip that file, and it will then come in as a folder, and there's that folder. Okay, let me just close the Save As dialog box out, and let's take a look at that folder. I'll bring that up right over here. Here we go. So here is the folder. This is my Photoshop Brushes folder. Keep all the stuff in. There is the unzipped cloud brushes. Double click on here, and there is the actual brush. You can see it says, say, .abr. That's the Adobe Brush, Adobe BR, Adobe Brush format. And again, this works in several of Adobe's programs, including Photoshop and also Photoshop Elements. Okay, so that's how you can download these things. I can find them and download them real easy. Just click on that download button right there. Now before we leave this, you'll also find more stuff from the same artist right over here on the right-hand side. A lot of times they'll have additional brushes in here as well, you know, brush sets. You'll find people are doing several brush sets, and you'll find those right over here. You can even view their gallery as well. Okay, let's go back to the brushes. So here we go. I'm just going to scroll down a little bit on this one in here, and you'll see as I scroll down, there are just an unlimited number of brushes in here. Almost anything you could possibly think of, anything which you want or are looking for, I'm sure you'll be able to find it here on the DeviantArt brush collection. And again, most of these are up here for free. Some of them may have a very small cost to them. Some of them may ask you to give them a credit or a link back. That's all fine. That's all fair. Obviously, they put the work into making these brushes, so why not give them some credit on that? But there you go. Here's where you can find thousands of free brushes for Photoshop, and they're easy to use. Let's now take a look at that one that I downloaded. Once you've downloaded a brush, the way you get it into Photoshop is go over to your brush, click on the little down arrow next to the brush sample right there, and then go up here to the little gear icon. Click on that. Come down, and you'll see Import Brushes right down there. And simply navigate to the folder where your brush is. So here's my Photoshop Brushes folder. All the brushes are in here. There are those new cloud brushes. Let me just open that up. Simply click on your brush and choose Load. It then loads that brush set into your current brushes. Now I've already done that, so I'll just cancel this out. And we'll take a look at those brushes. Now where it loads the brushes in is at the very bottom of your list. Just grab your little slider control, go right down to the bottom, and there are those letter brushes. Let me just pull that up a bit so it's not quite so far on the screen. There we go. Cloud brushes right there. Just open that up. And I'll scroll that down actually quite a bit. And so we can see all those brushes. There we are. All of these different cloud brushes. Now again, they're showing streaks in here. This is just the way that Photoshop shows a brush use. To really see these brushes, click on a brush. Over here you can see kind of the brush in there. That's the general basic shape, but it doesn't really give you a good idea of what that brush is. Before I begin playing with some of this stuff here, let's take a look at the layers over here. On the background I have a medium blue to a little lighter medium blue gradient. This is just gives me kind of a sky color in there. And then a blank layer above that. And then I have my foreground color set at white. It just works out well for clouds. Obviously they're white clouds, so white foreground color. Okay, back to our brushes again. I'll just click once. You can see there it is. It's actually a photograph of some clouds. And I can come in here and click a few times and begin to make a series of clouds. Now if you use just one brush over and over, it'll begin to look kind of repetitive and not that realistic. So you want to come down and do a few different clouds. Let me just do just a couple of different clouds in here so you can see what these things will do. Again, that's kind of repetitive in there. But you can come in and by bringing more clouds on top, you can break up some of that repetitive look. And just use the different brushes to build your cloudscape. I'm just going straight down one at a time here and just seeing what's available. I think that's kind of a nice kind of a fuzzy thing in there. Now to really get this so it looks more realistic on some of these fuzzier clouds, all you have to do is change your brush settings for the cloud to put some randomness into that. Let me show you how that's done. Let's go up here to Window, come down to Brush Settings. Here we are, go up to Shape Dynamics, and then just bring your size jitter up a little bit, and bring your minimum and your angle jitter up a little bit, and roundness jitter up a little bit maybe. Bring all these things up, and it just puts in some randomness into the whole look of the cloud. That's pretty good, there's some randomness in there. And then as I click on that, it moves it around and changes the size, giving me a much more random effect. So you don't have that look of repeating clouds like we kind of see up here. Now this works better on these wispy cloud shapes like that. Much better on those wispy clouds. Not as good on this more regular photographic cloud. So I would recommend using the wispy clouds, build kind of a background, maybe toss in some of these to give your upper edge. It would take a little bit, you know, this particular cloud set, it would take a little bit of experimentation to see what you have in here and play around with that to begin to build a nice cloudscape. But with just a little bit of experimentation, I think you'll be able to do a real nice job on that. So that's kind of nice background clouds in there. There we go. So there it is. That's just one example of the kind of brush set that you can get for free over there on DeviantArt. Let me just show you that page one more time again. Here we go. And again, don't worry about the link. I'll put this link on my video page, video support page. It's called the download page. You'll find that down there in the description. Just go to that page and you'll find this link right down there. So just click on that and you're right in here to DeviantArt. Now one more thing you may want to do if you haven't really used DeviantArt before, it's a membership-based site. You can use it for free. You can download these things for free without being a member, but it's nice to give them a little bit of a membership price. Now they're not asking much. It's a basic membership is $5 a month. So I think it's a good way to go in and just support the DeviantArt site. But give them just a couple of bucks, that way $5 a month, not a big deal. And that helps us support the site and gives us access to all of these great features. It's also a real nice portfolio page as well, portfolio site as well. Take a look real fast here on my profile. Click over here, here we go. And look at my gallery right there. This is a real nice place to come in and showcase some of your work. There we are, just a few things that I've done on YouTube. Okay, there it is. That is, again, my favorite spot in here, my favorite place for finding free brush sets, and it's the DeviantArt.com website. If you like this video, like what you learned here, make sure you click that share button and share this video with your friends. That helps me keep this whole YouTube channel going. And also, don't forget to take a look in the description for my complete Photoshop training course. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.